of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Today we celebrate the Synaxis of the holy angels, three of whom we know by name and celebrate appropriately: Michael, the commander of the bodiless host; Gabriel, the great archangel who proclaimed the good news to the Virgin Mary; and Raphael, the archangel who traveled with the servant Tobias on the miraculous journey that we read about in the book of Tobit in the Old Testament. One of my favorite theologians, Dionysius the Areopagite, writes extensively about the holy angels in his work, Celestial Hierarchy. And it is from there that we learn more about the nine holy orders of angels. And that number nine comes about many times in our worship. At every single liturgy, the priest, during the proskuneo, sets apart nine triangles, each for the orders of angels. And the bodiless powers, the hosts of heaven, are unique and special, because each one of them is delineated by not their race, not their type of angel, but rather their role. And because they are bodiless, their form can take any form for us. Beginning with the highest order of angels is the seraphim, which are the six-winged angels that serve in heaven. If you've ever looked at an altar boy's fan, you will see it's called the exipteria, which means the six wings, because the altar boys resemble the angels in heaven. Underneath the seraphim are the cherubim, and they are the ones that also have six wings, but on their wings are countless eyes, the many-eyed cherubim, because they are the ones who hold the wisdom of God. It is said that over the Ark of the Covenant were two cherubim holding on to the wisdom of God. And so when we hear the term cherubs, we don't think of a picturesque little baby angel, but rather a great angel that is the repository of wisdom. The next of the highest order of angels are thrones. Oftentimes in iconography, these are the ones that look like spinning circles. These are the angels upon which God sits upon his throne in heaven. After this are dominions. And dominions, I really don't know how to describe them except as middle management of heaven. They are the angels that organize all of the other angels. After that are powers. And powers are the angels that you often see held in the arms of angels. For example, in the arms of Gabriel in our door. And powers are the angels that enact miracles on earth. Perhaps you have heard of such miraculous stories as a handprint protecting a car door when the individual should have been destroyed in a car accident. Perhaps you have seen miraculous things happen. These are the work of the powers. The next of the middle tier are the virtues. Virtue angels are the warriors of heaven. These are the angels on the front line battling for your soul, their sole duty to fight the good fight for you. Hundreds upon hundreds of these angels fighting just for you. After that, in the lowest tier, we have the principalities. And the principalities are a unique type of angel because they are the angels that are in charge of groups of people. There is a principality in charge of St. Andrew's Greek Orthodox Church. There's a principality that is in charge of the metropolis of Chicago. There's a principality that is in charge of the state of Illinois. And if you pay attention to the prayers during the wedding service, there is a principality assigned to a couple when they get married, that an angel may go before them all the days of their lives. This angel's duty is to try to bring harmony and peace to that body, no matter how small or how large, to try to bring concord and peace to those people. The second lowest order is the archangel. And the archangel is the angel that brings great messages. Angelos in Greek means messenger. And so the archangels are those angels that bring the greatest, most important news to our hearers, such as when the archangel Gabriel brought the news to the Virgin Mary that she would conceive and bear a son named Emmanuel. Finally, the lowest order of angel, but the one with whom we have the most direct interaction, is our guardian angel. That special voice speaking to you, trying to transmit the wisdom of God to us. Is it any wonder that in the evening prayer services of the Orthodox Church, we have a prayer to our guardian angel, praying to our angel not to abandon us because of our sinful behavior, but rather to stay with us. Our guardian angel is so important and so close to us that people mistake sometimes our angel for us. In the Acts of the Apostles, when St. Peter was rescued from prison, the people did not know whether it was St. Peter or his angel. My beloved brothers and sisters in Christ, the final order of angels, which is not listed in the ninth, is the Virgin Mary, the tenth order of angel. She is the one who, as we listen to in the Orthros, is higher than the seraphim and more glorified beyond compare when compared to the cherubim. She is the queen of the angels who lived this heavenly life. So today, as we celebrate the holy angels, their synaxis, let us intercede that they continuously fight for us, they continuously do miracles for us, they continuously speak to us the good things of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ, that we might draw closer to him. For you see, my beloved brothers and sisters in Christ, just as there are nine orders of the holy angels, the inverse is true too. There are nine orders of demons, and every single angelic order that I mention is a counterpoint, because the demons are fallen angels. And so our angels fight against those demons for your soul. For each person, some of the fathers say, there are thousands upon thousands of angels just for you. So it is very important that we never, ever feel alone or think that it's just us against all of the powers of the enemy. You are not alone. For in addition to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, in addition to his Holy Mother, in addition to all the saints, we have the thousands upon thousands of angels fighting and working and speaking and striving for your salvation. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. I want to take a moment to wish Father Simeon a quasi-chronia pola, although Father Simeon took on a new name, Simeon the God Receiver, after he was tonsured and ordained into the Holy Priesthood. His baptismal name was Michael, and so we wish him a very wonderful secondary name day today. We also wish all those who celebrate today, the Angelikis, the Michaels, the Gabrielas, the Raphaels, the Raphaelas, all those who celebrate today, including my own parents. My mother is Angeliki, my father is Michael, and my niece, who is Angeliki, named after my mother. Happy name day to all of them and to all of you who celebrate today. May the angels always intercede for us. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.